All right, so I'm so excited because we are here. It is Tuesday, May 29th, 2018, and this is Manhattanhenge. This is Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson, your personal astrophysicist, and the man who named the event where we are, Manhattanhenge.
Okay, so I called it to everyone's attention.
Okay.
Of course, this has been going on since the grid has been up.
All right.
But nobody's been paying attention. You know why?
Why?
First, it has to be clear.
Okay.
Second, you have to be crossing the street.
Okay.
And not concerned about your health and well-being while you're crossing the street.
As evidenced by the number of people who are in the middle of the street.
Right.
Right.
And you have to be on one of the 2 days in which this is going on.
Right.
And I knew such a days would exist. I calculated it. My first shot of Manhattanhenge was on this very intersection.
On this intersection.
Park Avenue and 34th Street. The beautiful Empire State Building is right there. You check it out. Empire State Building.
Yeah, baby.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. New York State of Mind.
New York State of Mind. Okay, so then I published my first photo of it.
Okay.
And then people started gathering in the streets. And I said, look, traffic has been stopped for like Con Ed digging holes.
Right.
For pedestrians getting hit by cars.
Right.
I figured, let the traffic stop because the people want to drink in the cosmos.
Very nice.
Yes. And what such event is the alignment of the sunset on the Manhattan grid.
Where did you get the name Manhattanhenge?
As a kid, I visited Stonehenge. I was very impressed.
Very nice.
With the fact that ancient peoples made these vertical stone monuments. And Stonehenge itself is actually an observatory.
Yes.
And no one knew that until like an astronomer figured that out. People said, oh, they're worshiping the sun and they're this and they're druids and whatever. This is a freaking observatory that can predict eclipses. Okay. You know, just because they're ancient people don't mean they're stupid, okay?
Well, that is true. And just because we're modern people doesn't mean we're smart.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. Oh, we got a bus coming.
Bus.
We're in the bus lane.
It's like we're playing football back in the hood.
Okay. And so now, like, thousands of people pour into the street and stop traffic for a cosmic reason.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I'm totally into that.
This is your baby. You got to be proud.
I'm proud. Now, so this happens twice a year.
Right.
The same number of days before the June solstice as after. One of our challenges is in summertime, we get, as is true for most of the country, we got our weather from the states that sit west of us.
Right.
So our weather comes from New Jersey. From New Jersey.
Bus. Right?
And so if there's like storms and things over New Jersey, if the storm's over New Jersey, the sun will set behind the storms and we get no Manhattanhenge. So I'm worried about that. There's some cloud action over there. New Jersey might be messing with us again. Oh, another bus coming. So you notice how anytime we dig up old civilizations.
Yes.
We say, oh, they worship the sun and this is their sun culture. So I'm imagining the day where apocalyptic Earth and they dig up the grid of Manhattan. Okay? And then they try to figure out why was it aligned this way? So if you look at what is happening in American culture on those 2 days, okay? The first of the Manhattanhenges happens around Memorial Day. The second one happens near baseball's All-Star break.
Oh.
So future anthropologists would surely judge that we align Manhattan in honor of the two things America cares most about.
War and baseball.
That's right.
It's that simple. We're America. We love war and baseball.
So what's going on is people say, oh, watch this. What direction does the sun rise?
It sets in the east, so it must rise in the west.
So both of them are wrong. The sun rises in the east and sets in the west on only 2 days a year.
Okay.
And those are on the equinoxes, March 21st and September 21st.
And why is that?
And every other day of the year, the sun is rising and setting somewhere else on the horizon. Okay?
But why is that?
So I did a little Trump thing here.
No, you didn't. Somewhere else.
So what?
Somewhere fantastic.
So before today. What?
Bus.
The bus's butt is in the way. Okay, so what happens is the sun is setting at an angle. And before today, it has set south of this aligned street. So you would never see the sunset.
Right. Okay?
Beginning today, you see the sun cross this field of view, and today it's setting on the grid. Tomorrow it's going to set a little farther north and a little farther north. And it'll keep doing that until June 21st, first day of summer. Wait, let me finish.
Okay, go ahead.
Come to the north. And it sets its farthest point north on June 21st.
Okay.
After that, it starts, and the sun, so it slows down, stops, and that's why it's called solstice.
Right.
Latin for stationary sun. So after that, it starts setting backwards again, and it reappears here, and this would be around July 11th.
That's the police.
Uh-oh, police. They're worse than the bus.
Back up to the sidewalk.
Back up.
To the sidewalk.
Back up to, get up to the sidewalk. Back off the sidewalk. By the way, you're not supposed to be in the bus lane, officer. Excuse me, officer, you're not supposed to be in the bus lane.
Why did you say that when he was closer?
Well, you know, because I'm a coward.
So there you have it. Manhattanhenge, it looks like we're not getting it.
We're not going to get it because of the cloud.
That's Jersey cool. Took Manhattanhenge from us. They put a cloud in the way.
And that's the sun right behind Jersey. That cloud.
Yeah. Jersey did
it. You look at a
curse you, New Jersey.
If you look at a...
Chuck lives in New Jersey.
I do. It's my fault.